Hi guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, I'll walk you through how to forecast stock market prices. For this, I'll just use ChatGPT without writing any code myself. ChatGPT is a language model developed by OpenAI. It is specifically trained for interactions by conversation. ChatGPT is a game changer in the world of data science. We'll ask ChatGPT to write code, and it'll give us the necessary codes. We all loved it, didn't we? So, we're going to use ChatGPT for forecasting stock market prices in this tutorial. Let's take a look at what we'll cover in this video. First, we'll learn how to import a dataset with ChatGPT. Next, we'll discuss how to visualize data with ChatGPT. Lastly, we'll handle how to build a machine learning model. To show these steps, we'll use Jupyter Notebook. You can find the link to this notebook in the description box below. Before starting the video, for more content on ChatGPT, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. Let's dive in. Before building the model, we need to load our dataset. For this tutorial, we're going to use 2022 Apple stock market prices. First, we ask ChatGPT to download 2022 Apple stock price data with the iFinance library. Write me a code with iFinance to download 2022 Apple stock price data, and save it as a CSV file named applestockdata.csv. I specifically wanted ChatGPT to use the iFinance library, as it can output different codes for each prompt. ChatGPT started writing codes. Note that iFinance is a Python library that provides access to financial market data. It allows you to download and manipulate financial data from various sources. You can use the on-screen command to install this library. Look at that, ChatGPT explained these codes. It used the ticker class to retrieve Apple stock data. Okay. Next, it also used the history function to retrieve the stock price data for the year 2022. Lastly, it used the to_csv function to save the dataset. This is cool. ChatGPT wrote the codes for us. Thanks, ChatGPT. Let's copy these codes and go to our Jupyter notebook. Now, let's paste these codes into the cell. Next, let's run this cell. Oh my god. The codes ran without errors. This is amazing. We now have a file named applestockdata.csv. Let's go ahead and take a look at how to draw a line plot. Data visualization is one of the best ways to understand data. Let's draw a line plot of the close column. Let's say, hey ChatGPT, write some code to draw a line graph of the close column with Seaborn. Look at that, ChatGPT has started to write the necessary codes. Let's copy these codes and paste them into the cell. As you can see, a line plot was drawn for the closing prices. You can also plot graphs for other columns using ChatGPT. I gave an example to show how data visualization is done. Let's go ahead and build a stock market forecasting model. Machine learning is a subfield of AI and aims to automatically develop models using data. Let's build a machine learning model to predict stock prices. To do this, we're going to use ChatGPT again. Let's say, hey ChatGPT, write some Python code to train a stock market prediction model with the applestockdata.csv dataset. Look at that, ChatGPT has started to write the necessary codes. This is awesome. First, it gave the codes to import the required libraries. Next, it showed the codes to load the dataset with pandas. This is great. After that, it wrote the codes for data preprocessing. Next, it gave the codes to build a linear regression model. Lastly, it showed the codes to evaluate the model. This is cool. Let's copy these codes and paste them into the cell in our notebook. First, import the necessary libraries. Next, load the dataset into a pandas data frame. After that, perform data preprocessing. Next, train a linear regression model on the training data. Lastly, test the model on the test data. Look at that, our code worked without errors. The model we built predicts with a small error. You can use this model to predict Apple stock market prices. This is cool. That's it. Thanks for watching. In this video, I showed you how to use ChatGPT for machine learning. I hope this helps. Let me know if you have any questions. For more content on machine learning, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.